Although I like the command line, there are cases where using a graphical user interface can be a great productivity booster. Consider, for example, selecting some icons in a folder. So in this unit, we'll see how we can combine the two. Specifically, we will see how we can access the clipboard from Microsoft Windows, from macOS, and from many other systems that uses the X Windows system, such as GNOME or KDE. We'll also see how we can search for files on macOS based on their properties and metadata, and we'll finish with commands that allow us to launch any document from the command line. On Cygwin, under Microsoft Windows, the special file named dev clipboard represents the Windows clipboard. It can be accessed as a file from the command line.
To get the contents of dev clipboard, I run on it the fmt command, which stands for format. I also specify the -s option for split, in order to split long lines but not fill short ones. In my case, we see a letter written by Henry VIII to Anne Boleyn. To encrypt this letter and make it hard to read, we can apply the rotate by 13 places, rot 13 cipher to it. This is a special case of the Caesar cipher. To implement rot 13, I use the tr command and transpose all lower and uppercase letters from A to Z 13 places forward. In this way, A is replaced by N, B by O, and so on. When Z is reached, we rotate again from the beginning. I specify both the input and the output of tr to be dev clipboard in order to replace the plain file with the encrypted one. Note that this encryption is trivial to break. It can still be useful if you want to obfuscate a spoiler, such as a movie's ending.
Other Windows systems allow us to access the clipboard through a special command.
On an Apple macOS computer, we can use the command pbpaste to take the contents of the clipboard and pipe them to tr again to encrypt them. We can then pipe the output of tr to pbcopy in order to set the clipboard to the output of tr. On the X Windows system, we can use the xcell command with the --clipboard argument to fetch the contents from the clipboard. After tr, we use xcell --clipboard again in order to write back to the clipboard.
On Apple's macOS, we can use the MDLS command to access a file's properties.
As an example, I run MDLS on a Word document called study.docx and pipe the output to tail to get the last 26 lines. MDLS stands for metadata list. It gives us a variety of information, such as who wrote the file, when it was last changed, when it was created, its keywords, its title and subject, and so on.
On macOS, we can also use the mdefined command in order to find a file based on its properties.
Running mdefined with the query kmd item authors equals my name gives us a list of files that are written by me. A Microsoft Word document, a GarageBand file, and an HTML document. MDefined uses internally an index built automatically by macOS.
On Cygwin, the sigpath command allows us to transform paths back and forth between the Windows naming scheme and the Cygwin one.
On Cygwin, paths are represented in a different way than on Windows. We can use the sigpath command with the -w option to convert them to the Windows format, which we can then pass to Windows commands. Here, I convert the path tmp. As output, we get the corresponding Windows path, c/sigwin/tmp. We can also do the reverse, convert the Windows path to the Cygwin format. For example, I convert c/windows and we get as output sigdrive/cwindows. On Cygwin, Windows files are mounted under sigdrive, while similarly, under the Windows subsystem for Linux, running for example the Ubuntu distribution, drives are mounted under /mnt. Keep in mind that most Cygwin commands can also handle Windows paths. For instance, The variable $updata contains the path to my local documents and windows. See users DDS updata roaming. I run du dsqsearch on this path, and we see that I have about 600 megabytes of data stored there.
All Windows systems offer us a way to open, launch, a document from the command line.
To see an example, let's fetch from our friendly Project Gutenberg host The Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens in PDF format. On Windows, we can open a document with a sigstart command. Thus, by running sigstart tocity12p.pdf, the document opens on my desktop with the PDF viewer I have. On Apple macOS, we use the open command, again complementing it with the document name. On GNOME, the corresponding command is GNOME open. Similarly, on KDE, the command to use is KDE open.
This concludes our unit on fetching data from the graphical desktop systems. Stay with us.